All right, all right. It's only this next singer's fourth time singing in his pub, so cut him some slack. He's singing something new.
Hi. I'm Neil. I wouldn't be here if someone else hadn't passed on hosting, so special thanks to Shia LaBeouf for this opportunity. I can break your heart with a work of art and a song that's quiet and small, but we're back where we began it all. Radio City Music Hall. So tonight we might go bigger. That's right, it's bigger. It's Broadway's greatest night, and we're raring to go. Let's make it bigger. Tonight it's bigger. Who will take home a Tony statue? We don't know. I guarantee a truly legendary show. Season's new recruits include a cast of kinky boots. You know they're beautiful and buff as Navy SEALs. And you could bounce a quarter off the ass of Billy Porter. Lord, he does 8 shows a week in 8-inch heels. Hats off to Berry Gordy, he runs Motown like a boss. He dominates Top 40 and he banged Diana Ross. He wrote his own libretto, which is really kind of ballin'. He took every Motown classic and he said, I'll put them all in. Make it bigger. That's right, it's bigger. I just learned this dance like half an hour ago. We're going bigger, like so much bigger. You ever seen so many divas in a row? Well, stick with me, cause your MC's a seasoned pro. It's Pippin, never flippin', always slippin'. Find Thor's corner, what the sky. But the sky is overcrowded with his oh-so-highly touted cast of singing circus people flying by. Cast to bring it on, head count them 32 debuts. Hey kids, welcome to Broadway, don't forget your union dues. In tandem like we planned them, forgive me if it's random, but Mike Tyson had a one-man show. Let's give the man a hand and make things bigger. I'm here with Iron Mike, he's a heavyweight, yo. We're going bigger, the right is nigger. We've got cheerleaders, contortionists, and so hey, he'll go if a sports bar change the channel to our show. Go, Neil, go! The magical Matilda stole the show and nearly killed us, so they got a special Tony of their own. It strikes at the Achilles of the jaded former Billies. They get Tonys but get fired when they're grown. Now here's the kids from Christmas Story, Annie and her orphans. So many child actors high on Red Bull and endorphins. They barely come up to your knees, but God, they're singing like MVPs. And they're the reason this whole season seems to look like Chuck E. Cheese. And geez, it's bigger. That's right, it's bigger. Is there a Tony daycare where all of you go? You're getting bigger. The night is bigger. Do your parents set aside your Broadway dough? When I play Doogie, never mind, on with the show. Oh, Broadway's where famous people go. Though being famous doesn't mean that you will get a good review. So Alec, Wright, Ben Brantley, if you want, that's entertaining too. We've got magic to do. Bigger. That's right, it's bigger. I'm walking down the aisle with some newsies in tow. Yeah, no, it's bigger. So much bigger. If there's a newsie you prefer, please let me know. You'll get a newsie in your gift bag when you go. It's true. It's true. There's like 150 of those punks. Oh, wait. Hey, oh, check this out. Can I have my Tom Hooper Les Mis close-up, please? See, on Broadway, we don't need extreme close-ups to prove we're singing live. We sing live 8 shows a week. Check it. At the end of the day, we are gathered together to honor the best and the brightest. And tomorrow, the fashion police will report on your dress and who wore it the tightest. If you win, have the time of your life. Tell your manager, dad, and your mom thanks. Hi to your kids and your husband or wife, maybe just for the hell of it, Tom Hanks. Nothing is bigger and better than seeing a veteran get an ovation or seeing a brilliant beginner freak out on a win on their first nomination. There's a kid in the middle of nowhere who's sitting there living for Tony performances, singing and flipping along with the Pippins and Wickets and Kinkies, Matildas, and Mormonses. So we might reassure that kid and do something to spur that kid, because I promise you, all of us up here tonight, we were that kid, and now we're bigger. Tonight is bigger. So let's create the biggest spectacle we know. Come see the super sexy Cinderella sisters celebrating. Ladies, grab a fella. The tempo is accelerating. Spidey, Pippin, Motown, Phantom, Kiki, Rock of Ages. Chicago, bring it on. A Christmas Story, Sharon Stages. Mamma Mia, Lion King, the Jersey Boys are... Kathy Lee's a Broadway lyricist, so anything can happen. Bigger, New York is bigger. So welcome to our bigger, better, best of Broadway Sony Well, that's our budget. Good night. No, I'm kidding. We're just getting started. Please welcome to the stage our first two presenters, two super talents, Audra McDonald and Zachary Quinto.
That's the definition of a tough act to follow.
It is our pleasure to present the first award of the night to one of these fine actors who created moments so wondrous and inspiring that, apart from applause, the most fitting recognition for their stellar work is a nomination from their peers.
This amazing array of artists made contributions that were invaluable and that added to the excitement of the theater this season. The nominees for Best Featured Actor in a Play are Denny Burstein, Golden Boy.
Richard Kind, The Big Knife.
Billy Magnuson, Vanya and Sonia and Masha and Spike.
Tony Shalhoub, Golden Boy.
And Courtney B. Vance, Lucky Guy.
And the Tony Award goes to...
Courtney B. Vance, Lucky Guy.
Courtney B. Vance takes home his first Tony Award. He was nominated in 1987 for Fences and then again in 91 for 6 Degrees of Separation.
What? Thank you very much. I'd like to thank my the American Theater Wing and the Broadway League. I'd like to thank my wife, who gave me the nod, Angela Bassett, to do this role. I'd like to thank my children, Bronwyn and Slater, my Lucky Guy family, Tom Hanks and cast and crew, George C. Wolfe, George C. Wolfe, George C. Wolfe. I'd like to thank my manager, Steven Siebert, and the Gersh Agency, who pushed me real hard to come to New York to do this. And I'd finally like to thank my sister, Cecily, and my mother. Mommy, this one's for you. Which way do I go?
Something a little different, but I think it'll be kind of cool. As an example of support for each other here in the Broadway community, throughout the show, characters from running musicals will be here to make introductions and presentations. So now, please welcome to the stage Jack Kelly, Davey, and some of the cast of Newsies, the musical.
On Broadway, you make the front page. Man, use major news. Over at the Nederlander Theater, I lead a band of underdogs like me to fight for our rights.
10,000 working kids in the square, seizing the day and standing up to old man Pulitzer.
And up the road at the Schubert Theater, there's this real special kid, Matilda. She rallies her whole school to rise up against evil headmistress, Miss Trunchbull.
Now get a load of this. Matilda the Musical!
Well, children, there are winners and there are losers. You are small, shriveled, foul-smelling, and weak. You are losers, children, and you always will be.
Just because you find that life's not fair, it doesn't mean that you just have to grin and bear it. If you always take it on the chin and bear it, nothing will change. You could do a lot. You mustn't let a little thing like little stop you. If you sit around and let them get on top, you might as well be saying you think that it's okay, and that's not all right.
We are the revolting children living in revolting times. We sing revolting songs using revolting rhymes. We'll be revolting children until our revolting starts.
When I grow up,
when I grow up.
American Theater Wing's 67th Annual Tony Awards, presented by the Broadway League and the American Theater Wing. Coming up, Tom Hanks, John Cryer, Scarlett Johansson, Jake Gyllenhaal, and performances by Bring It On and Rodgers and Hammerstein's Cinderella. When we return, only CBS. The 67th Annual Tony Awards are sponsored by Cadillac.
So, this is my fourth time hosting. I love it more each time. But I noticed an inherent problem for people who produce and market the shows. Some people like plays, yeah? Some people like musicals. That's the problem. It's like a group divided. Who are you marketing to? So I have a great idea, guaranteed to make it easier. They're called playsicles. You combine a classic play with a classic musical, and then you get everyone, and everybody's happy. Hear me out. They're called mashups. I do them every year. They're rarely funny, but I enjoy them. The Elephant Man of La Mancha. Forty-second Streetcar Named Desire. Children of a Lesser God Spell. Think about it. Cats on a Hot Tin Roof. A tap number in there somewhere, I just know it. The Testament of Mary Poppins. Oh, man. What's Scott Rudin gonna write about that one? Too soon. A Midsummer Night's Dream Girls. That's a big number in there. Oh. The Diary of Anne Frankenstein the Musical. Too soon. Justin Bieber would love that show. I'm just saying. He'd think that was like... Cabaretsin in the Sun. Vanya and Sonia and Masha and Spider-Man Turn Off the Dark. That's current. That's a current one. And my favorite, Bring It On Golden Pond. Something to think about. Thank you. It's for you. I do it for the community. Please welcome two-time Academy Award-winning actor who is nominated here tonight, ladies and gentlemen, the one, the only, Tom Hanks.
Just last Wednesday at Sardi's, over the half-price menu for actors, in between shows, Julie Andrews said to me, that it wasn't until Broadway came into her life that she felt she'd made it. After being so warmly embraced by the community, I think I know what she means. This next award... This next award recognizes the achievements of the women nominated for Best Performance by a featured actress in a play. They include past winners and newcomers who have made their Broadway debuts to rave reviews. The nominees are Carrie Coon, Who's Afraid of Virginia Woolf? Shalita Grant, Vanya and Sonia and Masha and Spike. Judith Ivy, The Heiress. Judith Light, The Assembled Parties. And Condola Rashad, The Trip to Bountiful. And the award goes to Judith Light, The Assembled Party.
Judith Light wins her second Tony Award for Featured Actress in a Play. She won last year for Other Desert Cities.
Oh my, oh my, there are so many of you. This is such a gift. And you are such a generous community. I want to thank the American Theater Wing, the Broadway League, the Tony voters. I want to thank every woman that I am in this category nominated with. You have made this a celebration, not a competition. I want to thank Richard Greenberg for this beautiful play, this amazing role, Lynn Meadow for your generous heart and your brilliant direction, and my cast, my Jessica Heck, my Jeremy Shamos, and all of you. You know how much I love and respect you, and you also know that this would not be possible without your talent and your support. Our crew, MTC, everybody from our box office, our front of house, Bob Gersh, Jason Gutman, Jackie Ayton, Ivana Chubbuck, my husband, Robert Desiderio. Thank you for finding me again. Jonathan Stoller, for your love and support, and my manager, Herb Hampshire. If it were not for your guidance and your wisdom, I would not be able to be the actor I have always dreamed I wanted to be, let alone the person I wanted to be. And to all of you in this community, for your discipline and your devotion and your dedication, you lift our culture with your artistry. You inspire me, and I cannot tell you how grateful I am to be a part of you and call you my family. Thank you so very much. From Chicago, please welcome Thelma Kelly.
These are my boys. Our razzle-dazzle musical about fame, fortune, and all that jazz in the steamy 1920s has not only been thrilling Broadway audiences for 17 years, it was, of course, made into an Oscar-winning film. This season, another movie featuring a colorful crew of characters hit the great white way in Bring It On, the musical. In this number, Danielle and Campbell convince their fellow classmates to form a cheerleading squad, believing that they will grab the world's attention. They know that it's all happening. Ladies and gentlemen, Bring It On, the musical.
Listen up, this is how it's gonna go. We're gonna gather up every good girl we know. We'll get vertigo till we get vertigo and show these hoes how to put on a show.
We're the very best boys we can find.
They're gonna be strong and they're gonna be fine. Do what you gotta do, wine and dine. But keep this in mind. Imagine the nights, imagine the people. Imagine us in the middle of the crowd. Imagine the fame, imagine the fortune.
It's all happening.
Time of day, I start in a squad and they want me to play. And if I play, I'll be famous. Give me a hard one, these are no-brainers. I don't know what these other brothers are thinking. They must have been drinking, get it and let it sink in. What are y'all scared? Y'all think cheering is feminine? Then I'm a feminist woman and women, gentlemen. Consider it, it's a little different. Isn't it your thinking is limited? Give it a minute, envision it. Dead in the middle of 70 women on television. Every little bit of precision is magnificent. But
give me boy, middle of the crew.
Yes.
Locker rooms after practicing.
It's all happening.
The world reaction. When they see what Jackson can do.
Fellas, are you feeling my point of view?
It's all happening.
Come on, let's go. Oh.
No.
Let's go. Oh.
Don't say no.
Oh.
Noah here, backstage for Royal Caribbean International, the only cruise line to offer Tony Award-winning shows at sea. I'm here with the creepy cast of Rodgers and Hammerstein's Cinderella. They're performing next, and we've also got Alan Cumming and Scarlett Johansson. CBS, see you then.
Next, a performance from Rodgers and Hammerstein's Cinderella. The Tony Awards continue on CBS. Stop.
Just as the great kings of the past looked down on us from the stars, the work of previous Tony winners guides and inspires us. Our magnificent costumes won the Tony in 1998. Thank you. We presented Best Costume Design of a Musical this evening to William Ivy Long for Rodgers and Hammerstein's Cinderella.
Looking around tonight, I'm very conscious that it is such an honor and such a privilege to work in the American theater.
And the Tony Award for Best Costume Design of a Play goes to Anne Roth, the Nance.
I don't know if a man can be a muse, but Nathan Lane is my main guy.
You won't believe what is happening backstage. Mike Tyson just gave three of the four Matildas face tattoos. That last one can run fast. Please welcome two Tony winners, Scarlett Johansson and Alan Cumming.
Yes, ladies and gentlemen, it's the portion of the evening where two actors who are not nominated for their performances on Broadway this season very graciously give a Tony to someone who was.
We are delighted to present the award for Best Featured Actor in a Musical, and the nominees are...
Charles Brown for Motown the Musical.
Keith Carradine, Hands on a Hard Body.
Will Chase, The Mystery of Edwin Drood.
And Gabriel Ebert, Matilda the Musical.
And Terrence Mann for Pippin.
And the American Theater Wing's Tony Award goes to...
Gabriel Ebert, Matilda the Musical.
Gabriel Ebert wins his first Tony for his wonderful performance as the heartless Mr. Wormwood in Matilda the Musical.
Hi. I want to thank the brilliant creative team of Matilda who trusted and allowed me to step into their immaculate vision with my crazy alligator skin shoes. And I want to send love to the incredible cast and crew of adults and children who keep it real 8 times a week at the Shoobs. And to my beautiful onstage family, Leslie and Taylor, and my four glorious Matildas, Una, Bailey, Sophia, and Millie, come on. And lastly, to this room and to the Tony Committee. They didn't get the mic high enough, but just being in this room is really incredible. And to be in this category with these paragons of men, I am so honored and humbled and grateful and slightly freaked out. And lastly, to Scott and to my mom and my dad, I hope that I have done and shall continue to make you proud. This is incredible. Thank you so much. Let's make really good plays.
And now, from Rock of Ages, please welcome Lonnie and Dennis.
Got a dream, a fifth of Jack, and a decent amount of hair. Yeah. The Sunset Strip is the place to rock!
Lonnie, once we go outside the Helen Hayes Theater, it's not the Sunset Strip or the 80s anymore. These people want to hear about another fairy tale story that's also romantic and hilarious, but with a pumpkin, a glass slipper, and a masquerade ball. The ultimate makeover. Cinderella!
We don't do any Cinderella songs. We don't own the rights.
Oh, look. I'm talking about the show up the street from us at the Broadway Theater. Rodgers and Hammerstein's Cinderella!
In my own little corner, in my own little chair, I can be whatever I want to be. On the wing of my fancy, I can fly anywhere, and the world will open its arms to me. Oh, Crazy Marie, I am being foolish.
Then let's be foolish together. What shall we dream of?
An invitation to the ball, I guess.
Right here. What else would you dream of?
White gown, I imagine.
And on your feet, an entire pair of shoes made only of Venetian glass.
Well, you are crazy, Marie. Well, in order to do that, you'd have to be a fairy godmother. Marie! But you are a crazy woman. What are you doing in that beautiful gown?
You'd be surprised how many beautiful gowns have crazy women in them. And now, dear Ella, it's time to make all your dreams come true.
The impossible.
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 Impossible. Impossible. For the world is full of zanies and fools who don't believe in sensible rules
and won't believe what sensible people say.
And because he's acting dewy, I don't see building up impossible hopes. Impossible things are happening every day.
It's possible.
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 Jesse Tyler Ferguson, Jake Gyllenhaal, Cuba Gooding Jr., and performances from Motown, Annie, Pippin, and the Phantom of the Opera on the Tony Awards, only CBS. The 67th Annual Tony Awards are sponsored by Royal Caribbean International, the only cruise line offering Tony Award-winning Broadway shows at sea. Welcome back to the Tony Awards. Now, from last year's Best Musical winner Once, here are the characters known only as Guy and Girl.
Last year, we raised our hopeful voices in Once and took home 8 Tony Awards, including Best Sound Design of a Musical.
This year's Tony-winning Sound Designer of a Musical is John Shivers for Kinky Boots.
Massive thanks to our cast and our orchestra, these guys who sing and play their kinky butts off every night.
The Tony Award for Sound Design of a Play goes to Leon Rothenberg, The Nance.
The community of sound designers who work on Broadway and off-Broadway and around the country, it's an honor to be a part of the group of you.
You haven't lived until you've seen Mike Tyson in a pair of kinky boots. No, seriously, only 2 people have seen it, and neither of them lived. And now on behalf of the American Theater Wing, a pair of Tony nominees, Oliver Platt and Liam Neeson.
Welcome, everyone. I am the joyous spirit of comedy. And here at the American Theater Wing, we promote good cheer and laughter and excellence and happiness in theaters on Broadway and all across this wonderful country.
And I'm the spirit of tragedy. Screw you.
The Theater Wing believes in the future and the fantastic next generation of so many hopeful, gifted young theater artists.
So you actually believe in young people, Ollie?
Heck yeah, of course I do.
Watch your back, pal.
But Liam, the Wing provides a magical backstage pass to young and old, free of charge through its website, americantheaterwing.org.
Have you ever been backstage at a theater? Have you seen my dressing room here?
No, what's it like?
Well, have you ever used a porta potty?
You bet!
Add pillows.
Oh, dear. Oh, come on, can't you think of anything, one cheerful, positive, upbeat thing to say about the American Theater Wing, Liam?
You mean something like, the Wing offers something for everyone, whether you're a theater professional or just a fan.
I'll take it! Thank you and
good night!
Please welcome 2-time Emmy winner John Cryer and Tony nominee Martha Plimpton.
As someone who's been here a few times, I can honestly say that it truly is an honor to be nominated. And nominated. And nominated.
Yes, and I believe it's an honor just to be miscast.
These 5 nominees have assembled exceptional casts and given them the freedom to explore and encouragement to bring their individual theatricality to the author's material.
And the nominees are Scott Ellis for The Mystery of Edwin Drood,
Jerry Mitchell for Kinky Boots,
Diane Paulus for Pippin,
Matthew Warchus for Matilda the Musical,
and the American Theater Wing's Tony goes to Diane Paulus.
This marks the first Tony Award win for director Diane Paulus. She was nominated in 2009 for her staging of Hair, and last year for the Gershwin's Porgy and Bess.
Thank you to the American Theater Wing and all the Tony voters for this incredible honor. Stephen Schwartz, you are a treasure to the American musical theater. Thank you, Stephen and Roger Herson, for trusting me with your beautiful musical. To the American Repertory Theater at Harvard University, where Pippin was created. To my visionary board, my tireless staff led by Diane Borger. To the incredible Boston audiences that embraced this production when we first started, and to the Harvard president, Drew Faust, who says creativity is a form of knowledge. to Barry Weissler, Howard, and Janet Kagan, and all their producing teams for bringing Pippin to Broadway, to this extraordinary cast, Bettina, Matthew, Terry, Charlotte, Andrea, Rachel, and every member of our extraordinary ensemble, our musicians, our crew at the Music Box, Nancy Harrington, Mia Walker, my brilliant creative team who selflessly went back to the drawing board every time we wanted to make the show better. Lastly, I want to dedicate this to my family, my brother Stephen, who's here with me tonight, my sister Janet, my husband Randy, who's been my rock and inspiration my whole life, to my parents who gave me the best gift a daughter could ever hope for, the encouragement to do what you love with your life, which for me was the theater, and I can only hope to be as good a mother to my two daughters, Natalie and Catherine, who are at home watching. I love you so much. This is for you. You are my joy and inspiration. Thank you so much. And now, the nominees for direction, best direction of a play. Through their ingenuity and inventiveness, they've enhanced their productions in service of the playwright.
And the nominees are Pam McKinnon for Who's Afraid of Virginia Woolf?
Nicholas Martin for Vanya and Sonia and Masha and Spike.
Bartlett Scherer for Golden Boy.
George C. Wolfe for Lucky Guy. And the Tony Award goes to Pam McKinnon, Who's Afraid of Virginia Woolf?
Pam McKinnon earns the Tony Award for her staging of Who's Afraid of Virginia Woolf? She was also nominated last year for Clyburn Park.
Vegas got this one wrong, and Diane Paulus's speech was fantastic. So that's where my head is. I want to thank the Tony voters and my fellow nominees, and I want to thank Edward Albee for his fantastic play, and for giving my career a shape, for giving my career a spine. I want to thank my agent for suggesting 13 years ago that Edward and I have lunch. I want to thank my producers, starting with Steppenwolf Theater and our host at Arena Stage. And my Broadway producers, led by a fantastic team of people, Jeffrey Richards and Jerry Frankel and Susan Gallen. And my cast. My cast of Amy Morton, Tracy Letts, Carrie Coon, Madison Dirks. I have been so fortunate to work with these people whose emotional integrity, intelligence challenged me and opened me, and all shows close eventually, and this production will live in my memory for a very long time because of my cast of actors. Thank you very much.
Please welcome the company of the 2006 Tony-winning Best Musical, Jersey Boys.
Who would have thought that four guys singing under a street lamp back in Belleville, New Jersey, would one day become ubiquitous?
That our rags to riches...
To rags, back to riches...
...story would become a Broadway musical at the August Wilson Theater. And it all started the first time the four of us made that sound. Our sound.
This year, there's another triumphant story about beating the odds, shattering barriers, and making us move to the music of Berry Gordy's Hitsville, USA, and it's happening about six blocks away from us.
In Detroit.
This is their sound.
This is Motown.
And I'm bringing you a love that's true, so get ready.
Good evening, Radio City. This is such an incredible night, not just for me and the Supremes, but also because I get to introduce these phenomenal members of the Motown family. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the Jackson 5.
Coming up, Jesse Tyler Ferguson, Anna Kendrick, Stephen Van Zandt, Jesse Eisenberg, Matthew Morrison, and performances by Cyndi Lauper, Pippin, Kinky Boots, and the Phantom of the Opera on the Tony Awards, only CBS. A performance from Annie is next when the Tony Awards continue on CBS. And now, please welcome a Tony-winning actress, along with a three-time Emmy-nominated actor who began on Broadway, Jane Krakowski and Jesse Tyler Ferguson.
Hello, Jesse.
Hello.
I like your tie.
Oh, thanks.
You look very smart.
Thank you. You look stunning as ever.
Thank you. We look like the top of a straight wedding cake.
A fabulous straight wedding cake. Holla.
Earlier tonight, before you at home joined our celebration of the Best of Broadway, we got to present the first Tonys of the night.
The award for Best Orchestrations went to Stephen Arimus for Kinky Boots.
To all of the orchestrators and arrangers and music directors out there that are making our shows sound amazing, I'm so honored to be a part of our community. Thank you.
And now it's our pleasure to present the Tony to the writers and composers nominated for Best Score Written for the Theater.
The nominees are A Christmas Story, the musical. Music and lyrics by Benji Pasek and Justin Paul.
Hands on a Hard Body. Music by Trey Anastasio and Amanda Green. Lyrics by Amanda Green.
Kinky Boots, music and lyrics by Cyndi Lauper.
Matilda, the musical, music and lyrics by Tim Minchin.
And the Tony Award goes to...
Girl, you're gonna have fun tonight, Cyndi Lauper!
With her first foray onto Broadway as a composer and lyricist, Cyndi Lauper wins her first Tony. No stranger to the Broadway stage, Ms. Lauper co-starred in the 2006 production of A Three-Penny Opera.
Okay. I know no laundry list, but, and I can't say I wasn't practicing in front of the shower curtain for a couple of days for this speech.
this, all right, I gotta thank my mom for sharing all that wonderful music. I wrecked all her Broadway musicals when I was a kid, the cast albums. That's how I learned how to sing. And I wanna thank her for sharing the music with me. I wanna thank Harvey Fierstein for calling me up. I'm so glad I was done with the dishes. I'm sorry, I answered the phone. And I wanna thank Broadway for welcoming me. You know, this city, I understand how hard you work, and I've never been a stranger to hard work, but your hard work inspires me. And thank you, Jerry Mitchell and Stephen Aremus and Harvey, who walked me through this process, and Hal and Daryl and this wonderful cast, and Billy Porter, who is electric on that stage. And Stark Sands, who gives dignity to Charlie and Anna Lee and Don, Danny, I could call him this character's name, that's how lost I got in it, but, and my family, my wonderful family, my son and my husband who inspire me, and Declan, thank you for inspiring me about the sound, and John Shivers for making our music sound so great, and all you wonderful, you know, everybody else in my category, I feel honored to be part of this community, and you guys inspire me, and my wonderful team, and especially Sammy James Jr., and thank you very, very, very much.
Very cool, and now, from Spider-Man Turn Off the Dark, please welcome Spider-Man.
With great power comes great responsibility, but not all comic strip characters can spin webs and battle villains during high-flying theatrical adventures. Some, like a little orphan, use their powers of optimism to triumph over crooks, injustice, and a hard-knock life. Of course, a little luck and a billionaire with high-powered friends are a big help to this comic strip heroine. The timeless story of Annie is back.
Little girl. socks and each little bloomer. I'd have cracked years ago if it weren't for my sense of humor.
Again, for Royal Caribbean International, there's a lot of action going on backstage now. We've got performances from Pippin and Fenrir the Opera coming up, plus Oscar winner Cuba Gooding Jr., Anna Kendrick, Stephen Van Sant. It's all coming up on the Tony Awards, only CBS. Annie!
More live performances are next when the Tony Awards continue on CBS. Welcome back to the Tony Awards. And now from Newsies the Musical, please welcome back Jack Kelly and the Newsies.
Headlines don't sell papes. Newsies sell papes.
And you know what sells tickets? Tonys.
Last year, we got the Tony for the best dancing on Broadway.
Tonight, we's presenting this year's Tony for Best Choreography to Jerry Mitchell for Kinky Boots.
You know what? Here's the truth. I believe that everyone at that theater would walk through a wall for me. But you know what? I'd walk through it first for them.
So, you regret it? I feel bad that you had to. I'm sorry. Hey, come here. It's Andrew Rannells, everybody. Come on up. Sorry, that was bad. Sorry. Andrew Rannells, good friend of mine. He was in The Book of Mormon, which won the Tony for Best Musical 2 years ago. Yeah. And then he quit the show, and he moved to Los Angeles, and he got a series which was canceled.
That's sweet of you to say, Neil. There's a lot of great things about being on a TV show.
That's true.
The perks,
yep.
The pay,
ooh.
The private jets.
Sometimes.
Yeah, but it's something like doing live theater. You know, that's where I have my roots. I like to be on a TV show. Yes. Yes, the theater, Neil. The theater will always be my true home. I like to be on a TV show.
Why do you keep
And I know that no matter how many sitcoms or groundbreaking cable series I'm a part of, I'm talking about Girls, that show wasn't canceled. I know that Broadway will always welcome me back with warm and open arms. I like to star in a TV show, move walk popular on a TV show, chauffeur in car with a TV show.
That's if you are on a TV show.
I mean, I love the theater, but no matinee on a TV show, no to a day on a TV show, no at least pay on a TV show.
If you can stay on a TV show.
Well, now you're just being a douche. Well...
Hey, boy.
Don't work your agent submissions, that'll call auditions. Don't think it won't get too far. But you gotta have a series if you wanna be a star.
So can't.
Land a Broadway show, sure, but if you want exposure, a sitcom helps to burnish your name. You gotta have a series if you wanna shot at fame. I'll drink to that.
Laura Benanti, canceled twice.
Here's to the with shows, making tons of bucks.
She's drinking, too.
Lining up their ducks in proverbial rows, lucky sons of schmucks. Both my shows were canceled, it's true. No joke, not one show, but two. And so I raise a bottle to you, television stars.
No, no, Laura, stop, stop. Now you're just being bitter.
Yeah, yeah. Can't all be Will Chase. You know, his show got canceled. At least he's nominated for something tonight.
Yeah, he wasn't even on the second season of Smash.
Yeah, suck it, Will Chase.
Suck it, Will Chase.
Suck it.
No, no, Will, don't suck anything. Listen. Guys. Doing TV has its pros and cons, right? But just like the theater, sometimes you have a hit and sometimes you don't. We can't all have long-running hit TV shows like my own. And even though your shows may have been canceled, the upside is that you can always, as they say, come home to the theater. Kiss LA goodbye. It's back to four-show weekend. Deli food and sketchy equity insurance packages.
Forget, can't forget what I did for
an obscene amount of money.
What I did for
a really cool loft in Tribeca.
What I did for
the chance for producers and directors and writers and casting directors and just, well, everybody to see me and love me, because after all, that's essentially what we all crave, because nobody ever hugged us as children, which is why we got into this business in the first place.
Huh.
What I did do for
coming to a dinner theater near you. And now, please welcome an Academy Award-nominated actress who made her Broadway debut in the musical High Society and an Oscar-winning actor currently on Broadway in The Trip to Bountiful, Anna Kendrick and Cuba Gooding Jr.
Here we are. We're honored to present the five enormously, okay. I knew this was gonna happen.
Oh.
I knew it was gonna happen. It's too far away.
It's all right.
Hang on.
Do you want to switch?
No, no,
girl,
I got it. I got my pimp shades.
Okay.
Don't worry about it. We're honored to present the five enormously talented women nominated for Best Performance by a featured actress in a musical.
Whether stopping the show with a song, a dance, or a number that soars high above the stage, their inspired performances represent not only the measure of the artists, but the present state of the art.
The truly outstanding nominees are Anna Lee Ashford, Kinky Boots.
Victoria Clark, Rodgers and Hammerstein's Cinderella.
Andrea Martin, Pippin. Lauren Ward in Matilda the Musical. And the American Theater Wing's Tony goes to Andrea Martin, Pippin.
With five nominations for acting, Andrea Martin takes home her second Tony Award. She won in 1993 for My Favorite Year.
Oh my gosh. I ran up here like a longshoreman because I know we only have 75 seconds. I'm so sorry. Carmen Mark Valvo gave me this dress. Nobody else would. Anyway, I just want to thank him. Listen, I'm so nervous, and I'm going to put this down. Because I know it's such a collaboration, this show, and I don't want to forget anybody. And I wrote this speech out, but the font is too small, so I'm really scared I'm not going to be able to read it. So I love Pippin. I love the cast of Pippin. Each one is a singular artist. Thank you all so much, by the way, for voting for me. I'm so all over the place. Each one is an artist, and it's a privilege to share the stage with him. Yannick Thomas, my partner in the sky. Je t'adore. Jamais deux sans trois. Do you know how wonderful it is for a woman of my age to be held in a man like that and never dropped? It's unbelievable. Gary Gersh at Innovative, Perry Zimmel, my manager, Michael Oscars, my agent of over 40 years in Canada. Thank you for your unwavering love and support. The Weislers, the Kagans, our producers, and Diane Paulus, our extraordinary director, for giving me this opportunity. Oh my God, Gypsy Snyder for making a dream come true and letting me run away with a circus. You're brilliant. To Chet, I'm going to read this. To Chet, Brad, Dominique, Scott, Kenny, Nancy, Charlie, Nadia, Mia, everybody I've ever trained with, and the brilliant Nathan Lane, my darling friend, for your inspired collaboration. To the crew, Michael, our rigger, for keeping us safe. Who did I forget? Roger, what does that say? Oh, Herson, and Stephen Schwartz, who wrote this thrilling musical. Thank you so much. My boys, Jack and Joe, you are the reason I'm standing here. Thank you so much. Thank you.
And now a musician who made his Broadway debut as a writer, director, and producer, Stephen Van Zandt.
Well, it's great to be back on TV on a Sunday night. Tommy, it's a Sopranos reference. No matter where you come from, it's every performer's dream to play Broadway. And this season, that dream came true for me when I wrote and co-directed with my good friend Mark Brickman, The Rascals Once Upon a Dream, bringing their great story to Broadway and reuniting one of the most influential and artistically important American bands in rock and roll history, The Rascals. We were proud to be part of a Broadway season that saw its share of reimagined classics, inspired new work, joy, tears, and in the words of one of the Rascals' number one hits, a lot of good loving.
One, two,
three.
A big
Eisenberg, Jake Gyllenhaal, and performances from Cyndi Lauper, A Christmas Story the Musical, Kinky Boots, Pippin, and a 25th anniversary tribute to the Phantom of the Opera on the Tony Awards, only CBS. And now a playwright and Academy Award nominee, Jesse Eisenberg.
This year, the Broadway League announced that a record number of plays were produced. The curtain went up on a total of 46 productions, including the four original pieces nominated for Best Play. This broad spectrum of new work by celebrated authors dares to invite an innovative approach to history and brings theatrical vitality to contemporary issues. A sprawling 14-room apartment on New York's Central Park West is the setting for our first nominee, Richard Greenberg's The Assembled Parties. This delightfully funny and heartwarming new work invites us into the world of the Bascoves, an accomplished but eccentric family gathering for two holiday dinners 20 years apart. At the dawn of a new millennium, this fascinating clan finds that the only way to hold on to their traditions is to hold on to each other.
Don't be disingenuous. Just pass me the Valium, please.
Wait till I get you some water, at least.
Water isn't necessary. Water is a garnish.
Next, Lucky Guy. Smoke-filled newsrooms and bars set the scene for the late Nora Ephron's lively tribute to her beloved New York City during the scandal-ridden 1980s and 90s, as lived by the charismatic and controversial tabloid columnist Mike McAleary. From his sensational reporting of police corruption to the lawsuit that nearly ended his career, the play celebrates McAleary's meteoric rise, fall, and ultimate Pulitzer Prize win.
You know that big cop scandal in the 72nd precinct, the Buddy Boys or the 7-7? I uncovered that.
You uncovered.
I am that guy. And I'm not going to be a reporter forever. At some point, I'm going to have a column.
The next Jimmy Breslin.
Bigger than Breslin.
The Testament of Mary. Set in the ancient town of Ephesus, the docile image of the Mother of Christ is forever transformed in Colum Tobin's provocative play. This haunting portrait presents a woman living in fear and exile years after her son's crucifixion. Emerging as an eloquent heroine, she breaks the silence surrounding what she believes to be his meaningless death.
He is to be crucified. When? In a short time. And you must get away from here because they will come looking for his followers. I am not one of his followers!
Finally, Vanya and Sonia and Masha and Spike. A farmhouse in Bucks County, Pennsylvania is the home to Christopher Durang's hilarious and touching comedy. After caring for their ailing parents, Vanya and his stepsister Sonia are left feeling trapped and regretful. Meanwhile, their successful movie star sister Masha travels the world, returning for a sudden visit with her young boy toy, Spike.
I'm sorry, who is Spike? Is he your driver?
He's my beloved.
He looks 10.
Don't exaggerate. He's 29 if he's a day. And I'm only 41, possibly 42.
And the Tony Award goes to Vanya and Sonia and Masha and Spike.
Accepting the award for Vanya and Sonia and Masha and Spike, author Christopher Durang and producer Emily Mann.
Oh, thank you for this incredible honor. Thank you to the League and to the Theater Wing and to the Broadway community for this incredible honor. From the moment McArdle Theater commissioned Christopher Durang to write Vanya Sonia, this has been nothing but a blessing. Our great thanks to McArdle's Tim Shields and Mara Isaacs, our incredible staff, our absolutely awesome shops, our trustees, donors, and subscribers, and to Princeton University, thank you. This could not happen without your incredible support. And thanks to Lincoln Center's Andre Bishop and Bernie Gersten for a dream partnership, to Larry Hirshhorn and Jerry Parnes and the whole producing team for taking this amazing leap of faith and making it look so easy. The brilliant director, Nicholas Martin, Thank you for your gorgeous and stunning work. The team of designers, David, Mark, Emily, and Justin, for your gorgeous contribution and the phenomenal cast. Chris is going to talk more at length. I know I have only 43 seconds, so thank you. Thank you. Thank you to the cast for your incalculable contribution. But truly, everyone up here tonight is here because Christopher Durang wrote a magnificent play.
Thank you. Thank you very much. I'm very thrilled to win this. I wrote my first play in second grade in 1958. It is now 2013. It's been a long road, but I'm very happy to be here. Thank you, Emily and Andre. Thank you, all the nonprofit theaters around the country. You're so important to us. Thank you, Joey and Larry and all the co-producers for getting us to Broadway. Thanks to my agent, Patrick Harold. Thanks to my partner of 25 years, John Augustine. I adore our director, Nikki Martin, and the wonderful cast, Genevieve Angelson, Shalita Grant, Billy Magnuson, the great David Hyde Pierce, the one and only Christine Nielsen, the magical and bravely hilarious Sigourney Weaver. One more thing, my mother died when I was 30, and I feel she wants to thank you tonight as well. Thank you.
So Sandy from Annie is with me because we're both huge fans of musical comedies, and he knows everything there is to know about our next nominee for Best Musical. Should I tell everyone what it is? Okay, I'll take that as a yes. Just like the movie, it's about Ralphie's quest to get an official Red Ryder carbine action, give a dog a bone, 200 shot range model air rifle for Christmas. It's got the kids in the snowsuits and even the dad who wins the leg lamp. Oh. Plus, great singing and dancing like you're about to see. You do know I'm in a relationship, right? Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the company of A Christmas Story, the musical.
You don't need a steed to be a cowboy. You're not a hero just by galloping off in the sun. What you really need to be a cowboy, fearless, keeping bandits trembling on the run. It's a Red Ryder carbine action BB gun.
All right, class, I have your Christmas themes graded for you.
I held my breath as I stared at my paper. I knew the multiple pluses would be fairly dripping to the floor. But there was only one plus!
C plus.
Take him away, boys!
C plus, not an A, not a B, but C plus. Hey!
Meet the gal who makes the great. Here she comes to serenade. Who can face the power she wields?
Ladies and gentlemen!
Your theme was good for a laugh.
You shoot your eye out.
You're barely 9 and a half. Don't shoot your eye out. Seems like your big dreams ought to be left on the shelf. Why aim for the sky? If you're not careful, kids, you'll shoot yourself. I'm sure you're sick of my spiel, but even you shoot your eye out. And though you but a real good try, I'm at that cute regret, retina, little bullet crack, your retina, you'll shoot your heart.
You'll shoot your eye out.
Thank you.
Coming up, Sally Field, Jake Gyllenhaal, Sigourney Weaver, Matthew Morrison, and performances from Pippin, Kinky Boots, The Phantom of the Opera, and a special musical tribute from Cyndi Lauper on the Tony Awards. Only CBS. A performance from Pippin is next when the Tony Awards continue on CBS.
Anxious to have
Please welcome from The Lion King, Simba.
My father was a king who taught me that everything the light touches in the Pride Lands will someday be mine. But beyond our borders, there are other sons and other kings, like Pippin and his father. And like me, Pippin is a wanderer, searching for his place in the world. His journey is dangerous, death-defying, filled with acrobatics, magic, and illusions. It all begins as Pippin looks for his meaning in his corner of the sky.
Everything has its season, everything has its time. Show me a reason and I'll soon show you a rhyme. Cats fit on the windowsill, children fit in the snow. So why do I feel I don't fit in anywhere I go? Rivers belong where they can ramble. Eagles belong where they can fly. Cheese to sour. Join us, come and waste an hour or two. Diddly-do.
Intrigue, plots to bring disaster.
Humor, handle by a master.
Romance, sex presented pastorally.
Diddly-dee.
Illusion, fantasy to study.
Battles barbarous and bloody.
Join us
live where everybody can
tonight.
Yes.
Yeah.
Cast of Pippin. Interesting fact, the entire cast of Pippin arrived here tonight in one tiny car. Now please welcome a Tony-nominated actress currently on Broadway in Vanya and Sonya and Masha and Spike, and the Honorable Mayor of New York City, Sigourney Weaver and Michael Bloomberg.
I just want to say what a tremendous joy and honor it has been to be part of the Broadway community this season, and we'll never forget a minute of it, so thank you. Mr. Mayor, we know that you are one of Broadway's biggest fans, and we want to congratulate you on the special Tony honor that you've received for all the support you've given the Broadway community over the last 11 years of your administration.
Well, thank you. Sigourney, thank you. It's not bad for someone who can't sing, can't dance, and can't act. Actually, I'm a triple threat, literally. But I'm happy to report that the Broadway League has just announced that more than 11.6 million theatergoers attended shows this past season.
And the wonderful experience they shared include the nominees for Best Revival of a Play. They are
Golden Boy, Orphans, The Trip to Bountiful, Who's Afraid of Virginia Woolf?
The American Theatre Wing's Tony goes to Who's Afraid of Virginia Woolf?
Accepting the award for Who's Afraid of Virginia Woolf, producer Martha Levy.
David Hawkinson and I, on behalf of the Steppenwolf Ensemble staff and trustees, thank Jeffrey Richards and his team, Jerry Frankel, Susan Gallen, and Mary Lou Rolfe. Jeffrey, your passion and your expertise have brought us here, and your integrity has made the journey a joy. We salute our colleague theaters across the country whose commitment with their artists and their communities to telling the human story enlivens the poetry of our collective life. With a special nod to the Chicago community where Steppenwolf has had its home for 37 years. And whose artists, theaters, audience, critical community, and civic leadership are committed to a rich cultural life and have made Chicago a great, great theater town. We are so proud.
Hey, Barrett Foa again for Royal Caribbean International, the only cruise line to offer Tony Award-winning shows at sea. This, right here, is the place to catch all the stars before they hit the stage. We've got Mr. Jake Gyllenhaal and Cyndi Lauper. We're listening to her, Tony. She's getting ready to perform. So is the Phantom of the Opera and Kinky Boots. Tony Awards, only CBS.
The 67th Annual Tony Awards are sponsored by Pfizer. And now from Annie, please welcome Annie and Daddy Warbucks.
Production of Annie won 7 Tony Awards back in 1977.
Leaping lizards! That was a long time ago.
Annie, you have no idea. Earlier tonight, we presented the Tony for Best Book to Dennis Kelly for Matilda the Musical.
When I wrote Matilda the Musical, I really had no idea how to write a musical. So in many ways, this award is a ringing endorsement of ignorance and stupidity.
Please welcome a Broadway legend, 21-time Tony winner, Hal Prince.
Thank you. Thanks a lot. Thank you. On the 26th of January of this year, Phantom, the longest-running show in Broadway history, celebrated its 25th anniversary. There are some other stats that I think are maybe even more interesting. Of the five companies of Phantom that toured the United States, gave employment to over 10,000 people, 1,200 members of Actors Equity. And overseas, we played to 150 million in 29 countries, 150 cities, in 13 languages, 65,000 performances. Finally, and this probably pleases me as much as any of the other stats, we have 28 instruments in the pit, the largest orchestra on Broadway. And now, presenting a fragment from Phantom of the Opera.
Voice which calls to me and speaks my name.
You're not gonna believe this. In the fog, on his hands and knees, Mike Tyson pulling the boat with his teeth. Please welcome two-time Oscar winner Sally Field with two-time Tony winner Matthew Broderick.
It is our pleasure, both of our pleasure tonight, to present two Tony Awards to exemplary performers who gave their characters humor and heart and harmony. First, the men nominated for Best Performance by a Leading Actor in a Musical.
Five incredibly gifted artists, five diverse roles, each one original, compelling, unrivaled. The nominees are Bertie Carvel, Matilda the Musical.
Santana Fontana, Rodgers and Hammerstein's Cinderella.
Rob McClure, Chaplin.
Billy Porter, Kinky Boots.
Stark Sands, Kinky Boots. And the American Theater Wing's Tony goes to Billy Porter, Kinky Boots.
With his first nomination, Billy Porter wins the Tony for his performance as Lola in Kinky Boots.
Okay, so, I'm gonna put this on the ground. Yes, please. Okay, so, Shakespeare said, to thine own self be true. When I was 11 years old, my journey to truth began when I discovered the Tony Awards washing dishes in my kitchen, and the performance of Jennifer Holliday and the cast of Dreamgirls on the Tony Awards took my breath away. That moment, it changed my life, and I'm here before you today. I want to thank my family, the best sister that a brother could ever have, Mary Martha Ford, my mother, Clarinda Jean Johnson Porter Ford at home in Pittsburgh. You are the personification of true Christianity. Your willingness to embrace that which you don't understand with unconditional love is a template that the world could benefit from employing. Your courage gives me life, and I love you. To my Kinky Boots family, to the amazing cast and crew, and everybody at the Al Hirschfeld Theater, our producers, Hal Luftig and Daryl Roth, to Harvey Firestein and Cindy Lauper, who created the template that allows for me to express the journey of forgiveness and acceptance, and ultimately a necessary healing for my soul. To Jerry Mitchell for reaching back, lifting up an old friend, and giving me a space to soar. To my co-star, Stark Sands, you are my rock, my sword, my shield. Your grace gives me presence. I share this award with you. I'm gonna keep it at my house, but I share it with you. To my glam squad, who keeps Miss Lola fierce every day, I love you. To my patrons, Susie Deeds, George C. Wolf, Tracy Brigden, the city, Bill Butler, my manager of 22 years, and everybody, God bless you. I love you, I love you, I love you. Thank you.
And now, five men whose courageous performances moved us to tears and laughter, warmed our hearts, provoked our minds, and touched our souls.
For their exceptional portrayals in revivals and exciting new works, the nominees for Best Performance by a Leading Actor in a Play are
Tom Hanks in Lucky Guy,
Nathan Lane, The Nats,
Tracy Letts, and Who's Afraid of Virginia Woolf?
David Hyde Pierce in Vanya and Sonia and Marsha and Spike.
Tom Sturridge in Orphans.
And the Tony Award goes to Tracy Lutz, Who's Afraid of Virginia Woolf?
With his debut as an actor on Broadway, Pulitzer Prize-winning writer Tracy Letts takes home his second Tony. He won in 2008 for August, Osage County.
It's
overwhelming. This is for my mom and dad. They encouraged a love of the arts and an appreciation for the written word that have enriched my life beyond measure. Mr. Hanks, Mr. Lane, Mr. Pierce, Mr. Sturridge, you are not my competition. You are my peers, and I'm proud to be in your company. I share this with Amy Morton, with Carrie Coon, with the criminally undersung Madison Dirks, with Pam McKinnon for her expert captaincy, and with Edward Albee for his enduring work of art. And I share this actually with not only everybody in this room, but all the actors in Chicago and in storefronts, and everybody who does this crazy, insane, frustrating job, the greatest job on earth. We are the ones who say it to their faces, and we have a unique responsibility. I will cherish this always. Thank you.
Please welcome a Tony nominee last seen on Broadway in South Pacific, Matthew Morrison.
In the theater, when a colleague passes away, we dim our marquee lights in tribute. Tonight, we take a few moments to remember some of the cherished individuals we lost this past year. There were some tremendous talents, including Tony winner Marvin Hamlisch and one of tonight's nominated playwrights, Nora Ephron, with a very special performance to honor the passion and expertise they and others brought to our art form. We welcome a Grammy and Emmy Award winner. Her storied career has taken her from chart-topping hits to Broadway, first as a performer and now a composer. Here is Tony Award winner, Cyndi Lauper.
1, 2, 3, 4.
from Chicago, please welcome back Velma Kelly.
Good evening. I'll say something as soon as I have something to say. Thank you. Oh, we're over there. For our 1996 revival of Chicago, we rouged our knees, rolled our stockings down, and won 6 Tonys, including Best Lighting Design of a Musical. Tonight, this year's Tony for Lighting Design went to Hugh Van Stone for Matilda the Musical, and we accepted on his behalf. We also presented lighting design for a play.
Thank you so much for this extraordinary honor. This is really lucky.
Oh, I'm over there. Please welcome a brilliant stage actor and Oscar nominee, Jake Gyllenhaal.
In a season that brought us luminous work from leading actresses in new plays and revivals, the performances of these 5 women are singled out as fearless and stunning. The nominees for performance by a leading actress in a play are Laurie Metcalf, The Other Place. Amy Morton, Who's Afraid of Virginia Woolf? Christine Nielsen, Vanya, and Sonia, and Masha, and Spike. Holland Taylor, Anne. Cicely Tyson, The Trip to Bountiful. And the Tony Award goes to Cicely Tyson, The Trip to Bountiful.
A veteran actor of stage, screen, and television, Cicely Tyson earns her first Tony nomination and win for her compelling portrayal of Mrs. Carey Watts in A Trip to Bountiful.
The potter, I'm only the clay. When I think of the moment where I stand before you, this moment, I cannot help but remember all of the thumbprints that has touched this beam during the course of her career. My mother and father, my sister and brother, none of whom are here with me. I'm the sole surviving member of my immediate family. And I've asked over and over again, why? I now know why. It's been 30 years since I stood on the stage. I really didn't think it would happen again in my lifetime. And I was pretty comfortable with that, except that I had this burning desire to do just one more great role. I said I didn't want to be greedy, I just wanted one more. And it came to me through no effort on my part. Ben Ramsey, Hallie Foote, Michael, Bill Haber and the entire Haber family, who have nurtured me for the last 40 years. MJ, who has paid the greatest price for my success. The American Theater Wing for welcoming me home. Please wrap it up, it says. Well, that's exactly what you did with me. You wrapped me up in your arms after 30 years. And now I can go home with a Tony. God bless you all, and thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
And now, the Tony for Best Performance by a Leading Actress in a Musical. The nominees are Stephanie J. Block, The Mystery of Edwin Drood. Carolee Carmelo, Scandalous. Valicia LeKay, Motown, the Musical. Patina Miller, Pippin. Laura Osnes, Rodgers and Hammerstein's Cinderella. And the American Theater Wing's Tony goes to Patina Miller, Pippin.
Patina Miller wins the Tony Award for her marvelous performance as the leading player in Pippin. She was also nominated in 2011 for Sister Act.
Oh, oh God! Oh my God, this is an honor of a lifetime. This is a childhood dream come true for me. From a little Southern girl in Pageland, South Carolina, with a big dream of wanting to come to this big city and be a part of this thing, this Broadway community, and to be standing on stage in front of so many people I admire so much in this room, to the women in my category, you guys are inspiring, and I just am so in awe of all of you. I just want to say thank you to my cast, the most amazing cast in New York City right now, who knows? You guys, I could not do without you. This has been an ensemble effort, and I love each and every one of you. To our amazing crew at the Music Box Theater, to the creative team, Diane Paulus, oh my God, you visionary. Thank you for giving me this opportunity and believing in me. Chet Walker for giving me the gift of Fosse, Gypsy Snyder for giving me the circus. To our amazing producers, please wrap it up. The Voicelers and the Kagans and everyone else, thank you so much. To my mom, who has been my inspiration, thank you so much for believing in me and telling me that I could do anything I want to do. And to my stepdad, Tim, who we almost lost a week ago, I just want you to know I love you so much and I cannot wait to be with you tomorrow. And I know you can't see me, but I know you can hear me right now. And I just want you to know I love you. And finally, to my management, Jeremy Katz, Chris Hyland, my vocal coach, Liz Kaplan, but most of all, my honey, my fiance, who I love so much. I cannot wait to marry you, and you have made me the happiest girl in the world. Thank you to the American Theater Wing. Oh my God.
From Mamma Mia, please welcome Donna and the Dynamos.
Woo! Sorry to disappoint, but we've only got the breath for one number.
And we used it up on the walk out.
But we'll let you enjoy our sparkly platforms and our fabulous spandex.
I let out the seams.
We are wearing these fantastic boots to introduce a number from the high-heeled musical about an unlikely pair who joined forces to save a shoe factory and find out they have more in common than they ever dreamed possible.
As they work together to turn the factory around and be true to themselves, they discover that sometimes the best way to fit in is to stand out.
Let's hear it for Kinky Boots!
Yes! Woo!
Well, boss, is this what you had in mind?
Yeah!
Pull out the old way, cause it's been done.
We're getting ready for the new.
Witness the future of Price and Son.
Oh, Papa's got a brand new shoe. A life of broken heels got you down.
We got your solution.
No longer are we making shoes, we are making 2.5 feet of irresistible tubular sand. So let's do it!
Earlier tonight, special Tony Awards for Lifetime Achievement in the Theater were presented to Bernard Gersten.
Thank you, gods of the Tonys, for designating me a Lifetime Achiever and for providing me with an inscribed Tony.
Paul Libin.
Lifetime Achievement in the Theater is only realized through the very hard work of collaboration. I share this Tony Award with everyone who made it possible.
And Ming Cho Lee.
Everyone knows that I am greatly appreciative for the people who supported me.
The Isabel Stevenson Award for Humanitarian Efforts was presented to Larry Kramer.
Serious writers are rarely considered serious writers when they are also serious activists, particularly serious gay activists.
The Regional Theater Tony Award was presented to the Huntington Theater Company in Boston.
And with you tonight, we celebrate the proud, passionate, and resilient people of the great city of Boston, Massachusetts. Thank you very much.
A performance from Once is next when the Tony Awards continue on CBS. From Once, please welcome back the characters known as Guy and Girl.
Among our 8 Tonys, Once was honored last year for Best Scenic Design.
Earlier tonight, we presented this year's Tony for Best Scenic Design of a Musical to Rob Howell for Matilda the Musical.
I want to thank Fran, Tommy, David, and all the entire crew at the Schubert. They did a 5,000-piece jigsaw puzzle on time and on budget.
The Tony Award for Best Scenic Design of a Play goes to John Lee Beatty, The Nance.
We've got strippers, we got a burlesque theater spinning around, we've got a gay automat. How can I screw this up?
Please welcome 2-time Tony winner, Patti LuPone.
The nominees for Best Revival of a Musical enable new audiences to become captivated by revitalized and reconceived works of the past. We've been treated to performances from 3 of the nominated productions. The 4th completed its limited run earlier this season. Here's a brief look at The Mystery of Edwin Drood. Joining the mystery of Edwin Drood are Annie, Pippin, Rodgers and Hammerstein's Cinderella. And the Tony goes to Pippin.
Accepting the award for Pippin, producer Barry Weissler.
This is wonderful, just wonderful. But this does not belong to us. This one belongs to a company of actors and acrobats and musicians who joined together to make magic on Broadway. And I mean true magic. And we're privileged to be here holding this for them. You know, all Fran and I wanted to do in the theater was tell good stories in a theatrical fashion and touch audiences. And if we got it right, that evening had extraordinary theater. And I think we got it right this time. Janet and Howard, Fran and I have Diane Paulus, our Tony Award-winning director, our brilliant director, our marvelous, marvelous creative team, Gypsy, Chet, Nadia, the folks from the American Repertory Theater in Harvard, where we began many, many months ago. And of course, Stephen Schwartz, Roger Herson, and the one and only Bob Fosse. Thank you.
The 67th Annual Tony Awards are sponsored by Royal Caribbean International, the only cruise line offering Tony Award-winning Broadway shows at sea. And by Cadillac.
Welcome back to the Tony Awards.
Let's find out which show is going to win this year's award. To present, please welcome a two-time Tony-winning actress, last year's recipient of the Isabel Stevenson Award, Bernadette Peters.
The wonderful performances we presented tonight give you just a glimpse of the magic that you can experience live. When you come to New York to see a Broadway show or attend a production that's on tour across the country. Again, the nominees are Bring It On, the musical, A Christmas Story, the musical, Kinky Boots, Matilda, the musical. And the Tony goes to Kinky Boots.
Oh dear. Thank you, thank you. This is thrilling. And it belongs to our entire wonderful Kinky Boots family. They've given their heart and soul to making this story come to life so gloriously. We all yearn to be accepted for what we do and who we are. When we understand, respect, and accept people, other people, celebrate other people who might be a bit different than we are, we can change the world. That's the message of Kinky Boots. I'm so grateful to my family. I adore you, you know that. And we're all grateful for the joyous experience people have in the theater every night and for your warm embrace tonight.
Thank you. Thank you to Jerry, Harvey, Cindy, the entire company. Thank you to all of our co-producers. Thank you so much. I want to also just say thank you to Warren Trepp and thank you to my husband, Stuart, who every single day we're together. You make me a better person. I love you. Thank you.
Bravo, Kinky Boots. Congratulations, everybody. That's it. That's the best musical. This is normally where I do a closing number, but we are long on time, so we are not going to do that tonight. But I want to thank SH, I can't help myself.
Here's a Tony hit list, try to write them all down. First we started bigger than a Cinderella ball gown. Shout out to the ladies, all the women winning. Andrea Martin, Diane Polis, Pam McKinnon, Cindy Lauper talking in the shower, no baloney. Girls just wanna have fun, you just want a Tony. The 80s came back with a bang, not cause Cindy Lauper sang, it's because the best play was by Durang Durang. Heavenly, now I need a melody. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome in Audra McDee! In your face, Billy Porter's gonna keep the Tony at his place. Then at 9 o'clock, you change to watch the games. The nerds, Game of Thrones, the jocks, LeBron James. Now you're watching Audra singing to her own flow. Audra's got so many Tony, she can host her own show. Courtney Vance, Tracy Letts, Judith Light hit it. Edward Albee, Pippin, and Bettina Miller did it. Cicely Tyson, standing ovation. Kinky for the win, and the eyes of the nation are on.